I love reading bad reviews.
You do?
Oh, devour them.
Really?
I devour them. It's like, I mean, it's poetry.
On tour, if we get a bad review, do we want to look at it?
You can look at it, but only, you're not going to get critical feedback from a bad review. You get that from your friends.
Ask you or anybody here if I can be told to do anything differently.
No.
Some newsprint?
Yeah.
Mama, I shred it and line my hamster cage. That has nothing to do with me. Plus, I already got your money. All you're doing is complaining about something you already paid for that you won't get refunded for. It's like saying, I hate my outfit. You're wearing it.
Hi, I'm Trixie Mattel.
And I'm Katya.
And we are two queens who like to watch.
And we are two queens who will watch two queens right now, Grace and Frankie.
Yes, baby, this is highly requested. It's the final season, it's our last chance.
They're foaming at the mouth for Trixie and Katya to watch Grace and Frankie.
Because of my sense of humor, I think I'm kind of a Lily Tomlin, but because of my body, more of a Jane Fonda. Can I be a Lily Fonda? Or a Jane Tomlin?
I'm a Janie Jimplin. I'm a Jackie Jormdrop.
Now, spoilers ahead, in the nature of this program I like to watch, we're gonna watch.
So if you hate finding out about the future, just stop right now. The FBI comes to question Grace and Frankie about Grace's husband who happens to be in jail.
I think we're done here, Karen. Good to meet you, Mount Rushmore.
My problem here is that you two are the only ones in that apartment.
Okay, Karen. I know where you're going. I'm already there and I'm on my way back.
This is you.
Yeah, it's totally me.
Girl, that is you.
So you won't mind if Rushmore and I take a look around?
Actually, I mind. There's a little thing I call civil liberty.
Gay lawyers.
Oh, they're lawyers. Full heads of hair. Three times our age.
Mama, what? Rugs, girl. rugs.
Perhaps we should show these nice agents out.
By the way, this is an old gay flying off the handle.
Yes.
God, that was too close for comfort.
Oh, at least we got him off our trail.
This is us.
And I'll handle the money from now on.
I'll get the rest of the dough.
This is us. Holy shit.
Mallory leans in to her power at work and stands up to that bitch, Brianna.
You don't seem to know where your desk is.
June and Raphael. She cracks my shit up.
Not a promising sign for a supervisor.
I'm not your supervisor.
Exactly. Thank you, Mallory.
I'm really your boss.
Now get your bony ass out of my sight, bitch.
I love my brother. He's an attorney with his own office. I wouldn't last a day working with that bitch.
No. Gone by lunch.
You think this is my first game of Big Muffin, Small Muffin? I invented Big Muffin, Small Muffin.
I don't think that's what Big Muffin, Small Muffin is, if you know what I mean.
Do people call vagina muffin?
And no, ain't nobody talking about muffins literally or figuratively, okay?
Oh, I know that I have a small muffin and that you used to have a small muffin and now it's a very big muffin.
So Grace and Frankie are scrambling to hide the rest of the stuff before the FBI comes back and they run into
Robert and Salt
having sex.
Oh my God.
Look away!
Oh God.
Yes!
No! Get out of here!
Lemon Party.
Lemon Party.
You remember Lemon Party? Does anybody remember Lemon Party? I know one of these sick bastards behind the cameras remembers Lemon Party.
What is it?
You would tell someone, oh, go to Lemon Party. It's so cool. You're gonna love it. And it was just a photo of extremely old men having sex.
Oh.
It was like a gotcha.
The painful afterglow of sex shame.
Work. Did it work, sunglasses?
Too ashamed. Yes. Can't show his face.
Gay shame is real. I'm sure late in life, gay shame is even worse. Are people that age having anal?
Of course they are. They're doing everything, Mama. They're hanging from sex swings.
I'm gonna finish my breakfast someplace else.
Frankie and her friend Joan go over to Robert and Saul's to pick up the money.
One measly FBI search, and now we can't keep the money here.
Well, you know, there is a way to hide money without hiding it.
Love this hair color. Is that a violet?
Yeah, it's like a dusty rose.
Work.
I'm talking money laundering, dear.
Could you launder money? How would you do it?
I would phone it through your f***ing cosmetics business.
Shh.
And that works?
Sure. But if it doesn't, you just start an electrical fire.
Oh, my God.
If you're a cop, you have to tell me you're a cop.
That's how I answer the door every day.
On trial, Nick turns the focus to Grace.
I am pleading for my wife to give me another chance.
Oh, my God.
It's a personal matter.
I just want to try another way for us to be together.
It's a perfectly reasonable operation.
You don't have to live together.
You certainly don't. Separate beds, separate apartments.
Separate husbands and wives.
Don't live together.
I'm willing to try.
Oh, a Whipple waffle brunch at the beach house.
These people are rich. Why are they stealing more money?
Rich people love to keep stealing. Rich people are all thieves.
So, who wants to share their favorite Whipple waffle memory?
Oh my God, no.
We should all share our favorite Whipple waffle memory.
Can we go back to the mom killed something story?
I'm killing this conversation.
Are they gonna casually tell a story of killing a person?
We killed a homeless man. We buried his body in the beach. It's fine, it's nothing.
You killed Bud's bunny?
You yelled it to death.
Can you yell something to death?
What we need here is the cover-up of the century. I know. Give me the rabbit poop.
What? I just cleaned that up.
I'm making it look like Bud's bunny made a run for it.
Do you think that bunnies spray shit out the door?
I know that they do.
Wiping fingerprints.
Okay.
That is so funny.
And we did not want to ruin your mahala. Am I still pronouncing it wrong?
It's a little more Fleming.
Mahala.
What's a mahala? Is
it Jewish? Sure, we'll find out. I don't know.
I'm sorry, what's mahala?
It's a Jewish holiday.
Is it a fake holiday?
It's a fake holiday.
You made it up. You made up a holiday to get out of doing stuff with us for years.
Mary, that's very my
girl.
Tea. That's very my tea.
See, you should never tell people the truth. No. If you have a lie, don't ever come clean.
People are going to start telling the truth around here. I'm going to bed.
Are you telling me M'challa isn't real? It's the celebration of bread.
Yeah, we prayed, lit candles, then broke fast with M'challa challa.
M'challa challa.
Isn't this an interesting turn of events?
Oh, no. Our thing isn't nearly as bad as your thing.
Oh, my penis! My penis! My penis!
Are you okay?
Does he seem okay? His penis is bothering him.
Forget me.
What? So Bud's gonna talk with the rabbi about getting a bris.
I'm thinking of getting a bris.
Bris? I'm here to paint your house. Kidding? just part of my shtick.
Yeah. And I'm going to take part of yours.
Oh, my God.
I've been doing this for 30 years.
Sober for 3.
Don't you think maybe we should get a second opinion from a doctor?
Doctor Schmachter, they charge an arm and a leg. I work for tips.
Oh, my God. This guy's got a whole thing. Brianna meets her boyfriend's family.
You all need to shove down. My left side's my good side.
Oh. It's true. Okay. It's true. It's true.
Hey, what's your passcode on the phone? 382. You know what? It's fuck me. Okay? The passcode is fuck me.
Sorry, it's fuck my cunt. Sorry.
Okay, how about we get a silly one? Okay.
Let's get a silly one. That needs to stop in general.
When they say let's get a silly one, I rip open my pantyhose and show my dick and balls.
So Mallory and Brianna lead a team meeting and get a surprise visit from corporate.
Can I talk to you for a couple minutes?
Sure.
Not good.
When I'm in a room, I like to know who the big dog is. Newsflash, it's always me. But I also like to know who the big dog is when I'm not there. No!
Work. You know what?
Take a shit.
Corporate environments can be confusing. Yeah. It's kind of a game of chicken.
Yeah.
And she's going big.
She's going big.
And do you know what you are if you're not the big dog?
You're a piece of shit.
The little dog?
You're the second banana. Now I love a banana.
You know what? I like her style, though.
Yeah.
A lot of metaphors that interfere and dissect and make no sense.
Yeah. Love this rat race, you gotta be the big dog. Or the second
You know what? It's a shark tank, and you're either the rat or the tortoise.
Yeah. So spread those wings and fly.
Robert and Saul, they set up a little brunch here. And we'll say this, gays out there, it's fun to have older gay friends.
Well, yeah.
Nice houses, nice drinks, nice food. You got 20-year-old gay friends?
Nothing. Can I borrow your phone charger? Do you have any K?
The salmon tastes a lot like fish.
Jesus Christ, he is beautiful. Look at his body.
I enjoy watching you eat it more.
Feeding each other?
Oh my God, I'm gonna puke. If you ever try to fucking feed me, I'm gonna slash your tires.
You know what? I'd let him feed me a lot more than pizza. Buckets of uncooked dough. Just so much uncooked dough, vats of marinara. Baby, you don't have to cook it.
Oh my God, is that a Rolex Daytona?
That sexy idiot robbed us.
No, you can't make snap judgments. You're always wrong.
He's wearing my watch, Robert. The watch didn't even fit him. It was baggy. But I bet it would fit me.
That bitch is wild. Yeah.
Would you mind if I try on that beautiful, unique, hard-to-find watch of yours?
Hard to find? It's right here, silly.
Are we gay? No,
don't think we're gay.
I don't think we're gay.
Perfect fit.
Mallory and Brianna are gonna get in a physical fight in the office.
Come on, fight, fight, fight.
Are you trying to embarrass me in front of everybody? Because my in-laws saw my taint on first meeting.
Backstage on the Trixie and Katya tour.
Yeah, totally.
I took a job that you did not want at a company that Mom gave you.
She's got a point, T.
I wonder why she gave it to me. It's because she knew I'd be better at this than you.
Hit her, Malin.
Don't poke out on me.
A boob punch? Oh my God.
Kick her in the pussy.
Oh my God. Butt punching.
That is
butt punching.
This is much more true to life.
What the fuck are you two bananas doing?
Who's the banana? Who's the dog?
We need to march out there right now and confront him.
And confront him?
He robbed us. He's a master criminal.
These actors aren't gay, but I love that they're playing them cartoon-level gay.
I'm obsessed. Shooing up the scene. I mean,
if you're playing gay on TV, I want you to be Dorothy Gale, bitch.
Like, yeah.
Go big.
Nathan Lane winning a Tony yes. with three dicks up his ass.
Yes. Yeah.
I have something to tell you.
Wait, hysterical gay man.
I am sorry to say this, Peter, but your boyfriend, he's a master thief. Where do you think he got that watch?
What?
Robert. Come on, Peter, look at him. He could be with anyone. Why would he be with you?
You know, people have said that to every boyfriend I've ever had. And I don't appreciate that. Some of us love dating down. I love the ugly. I help them.
I'm sorry. I never should have said that about you and Stevie. But we had to say something about the watch, right, Saul?
Yes, he's wearing my exact watch, and mine is nowhere to be found. And I always keep it right here in this bowl, except on the rare occasion when I keep it in this drawer.
Boom. Fucking idiot.
May I say, Stevie, you have excellent taste in watches.
You don't accuse people of stealing until you know.
And even footage. Then, have you ever had to tell someone they stole? When I worked at a bar a long time ago.
Do you have footage?
We had footage.
Yeah, as long as you have footage.
We had footage of a girl passed out drunk in the dressing room, a drag queen. And then when everyone left, she got up, not drunk at all, took a bunch of stuff and went back to fake drunk.
Scooby-Doo, yeah. Shit.
Yeah, bitch.
Oh my God, that is fucking diabolical. That's a whole scheme. Grace and Frankie head down to Mexico to get their hands on some subscription drugs for their friend Darlene.
Not subscription drugs. Not subscription drugs, honey.
I do have Viagra that comes every month. That is a subscription. So Grace and Frankie
come every month.
I'm stockpiling them. I'm going to sell them at the end of the year.
In a pinch, your safest hiding spot is your holes. Frankie, not all of us are blessed with cavernous orifices.
Oh, you'll get there.
You'll get there. Damn, this is us.
I know. Except we'd be dead 15 minutes into being at the wheel.
And we wouldn't have to go find the drugs.
I know.
They'd find us.
My subscription would have
come in the mail.
We're here.
What? When did we cross the border? I didn't think it was that easy.
It actually is that easy.
It is?
The hard part is getting back with a keister full of drugs.
The hard part is getting out, yes.
Really?
Going to Mexico, cinch. Going back in, oh my gosh.
We need Bonita, lots of it. My name is Grace, and this is
Jennifer Nightingale for all your real estate needs.
She busted that out so quick. Jennifer Nightingale
for all your real estate needs.
I could lock you in at a really low rate if you're looking
Damn.
To refinance. Just here's my card. Oh my God.
That was so funny.
Oh my.
We're just here for the medication. Then you will be interested to know that I have called Border Patrol. They will be on the lookout for two old home wreckers smuggling drugs illegally across the border. Have a nice day.
Work, bitch.
Yeah. Would you be the spokesperson for a prescription drug?
Yeah, of course, if it was something I liked.
Like?
Coke. You know, something fun, like Molly, Kang, G.
Would you do, like, diarrhea medicine?
Oh, wait a minute. I've been in 9 prep ads.
Oh, that's right. You're basically a walking HIV commercial.
I've been in 9 prep commercials, and I'm like, would I do it? Prep was easy because I feel like it was almost like a public service, like,
Yeah, of course.
And if I took it, then people would say, wow, really cool people take it.
Yeah.
Someone who takes so many loads, maybe I should. So Grace and Frankie, or should I say, Grace and Jennifer Nightingale, yeah. Figure out a plan to get across the border.
Unless these two gals have Bonita, we're going to jail.
We're gonna switch cars, mix it up.
What? The Border Patrol is on the lookout for two older women, not two older couples. Look at these two.
Oh, smart.
We'll look totally natural.
That is smart.
It's super smart. Except he probably has a bunch of heroin.
He's got human body parts in there.
My name's Jennifer Nightingale, by the way.
That's too much.
Real estate is my game.
It's too much.
Condos, farms. I sold a zoo once.
Jesus Christ, Jennifer Nightingale. If we go to the border, you'd be Jennifer Convertibles, yeah. And I'm going to be Ashley Furniture. Yeah, guess what? The guys they're with turn out to also be drug dealers, yeah. So...
You're smuggling Bonita.
Well, sure. If Bonita is what you call 6 kilos of...
Cocaine?
Jesus. Why don't you just tell the whole world, Jennifer?
Grace loses Frankie because Frankie tucked and rolled at the border.
Where is Frankie?
I don't know who Frankie is, but Jennifer Nightingale did a Navy SEAL tuck and roll.
Girl, that is your tea.
She took Duncan's skateboard and just zipped right out of it.
Serious, dude? I just put those sweet trucks on.
Don't worry. You can buy yourself a new one with your money from the powder. Hey, nice doing business with you. Have a nice day.
Elizabeth.
Hello, Grace.
What?
Have you ever seen a psychic?
Oh, yeah. You just can't give him too much money.
I had a dark vision about something happening to Frankie 3 months from now.
That is just absurd. There is no way that you could know that.
You're right. I'm not that great at this stuff anyway. Bless you.
What? God damn it.
Saul and Peter devise a plan to prevent Robert from seeing the bad reviews of the play.
Oh, yes.
A week before opening night, I meet Shushman for drinks, sleep with him, and we get a great review.
Community theater, sex scandals. Would you go through this?
I would, absolutely. If I could f*** someone and things could get better, I would do that.
But then the pressure's on to have good sex.
I know. What if you bomb both ways?
If you do this every year, why didn't it work this time? So maybe it wasn't my best performance. I had Thai for lunch.
Thai bloats.
Who knew Shushman would be so discerning?
You know what? No shit on the talk.
You know, shitting on someone, that is their dream sex. So,
oh my God.
There you go.
Shitting and fisting, everybody in LA.
Do you know how much pornography is about actually ingesting feces?
Yes, I do. Do you know how many hot tens? If you're a 10 and you live in LA, 2 years, you're an idiot.
You're eating shit.
I swear
you're
to God.
You're eating it. It's crazy. Eating it. I'm sorry, is that a melted Take 5 bar in your sheets? Oh no, it's dinner time.
Grace finds Frankie at the restaurant and they get mulatto.
You are actually here.
Work.
Laying subtle. Low. Subtle.
We got a carload of Bonita waiting for us on the other side.
Oh my God, we did it! One celebratory margarita.
Just a pro tip here, you go to a lovely Mexican restaurant, you order margaritas, it doesn't stop at one. Margaritas are dangerous games.
Did Grace tell you the thing yet? Question mark, sad face. Did you talk to Elizabeth? What'd she say?
She said that, and this is, you know, according to her, that you were gonna die in 3 months. Which is absurd.
Oh.
No, you shouldn't believe it. I sure don't. She said you were gonna have 3 dessert tacos, and you've only had 2. What about that?
The cook made too many dessert tacos. You want it?
A beautiful moment is about to be shared here between Miss Grace and Miss Frankie.
In my whole life, there were only 2 people who made me feel safe, you and my dad.
Oh,
sad.
Are you crying?
No, I started to.
I saw a glitter piece.
I
know, it's like.
I'm like trying hard not to.
If I could, I wouldn't go anywhere without you.
So sad.
You know that.
I do.
Frankie throws herself a funeral while she's still alive so she can get a warm sense of how people think about her.
I've been there, babe.
I think we've all realized something today about this amazing woman.
that it's impossible to think about her without thinking about mom too.
I'll fucking try.
Okay.
Did all of you not get the memo that this was my funeral? One of you must have a story about Frankie without Grace.
That's when people wear Trixie and Katya shirts to my funeral.
Girl.
Rip it off of them.
One thing myself, I swear.
That's when people come to my meet and greets with a gift for you. I'm like, oh yeah, let me just get this for her.
Yeah. How is it that after everything I've done, every memory you have of me is with Grace? When did I become a sidekick to my own life?
Whoa.
So it's a little too close to home.
Whoa. This actually looks a lot like your funeral, to be honest.
I know.
How'd you get this gig? You don't understand commitment.
This is you heckling me at our own show. In the middle of the show.
Yeah, well, I'm changing in the wings.
Yeah.
And the light, and the right line.
You don't have the gall.
Yeah.
Girl, we are these people.
It's not death I'm afraid of. I'm afraid to get sick and not be able to walk or use my hands or any of the things that make me me.
Oh, big fucking deal. So you can't use chopsticks anymore.
I can't paint either.
I mean, neither can I. You know, perspective. Work, bitch. Oh, the drink is spilling.
She's gonna get electrocuted. They're both gonna die. That's incredible.
Great outfit to die in.
Yeah.
Well, hi, girls.
Oh, God. You look exactly how I knew you would.
I love that Dolly's like, I'll do the show. However, it has to be heaven lighting.
Yeah.
I need uplit, side lit, front lit.
Tiny black eyes and hair, and that's it.
Yes.
Nothing else.
You have to understand, there's been a mistake.
You know what? You're right. There has been a mistake.
You're going to hell.
Why you have the stamp out? Can you put return on mine, too? I really have to go back with Grace.
Oh, I'm sorry, honey, but that's not possible. You see, your name is on the list.
Oh, she's staying.
Oh, I think she's going to
go. It's Thelma and Louise. No, it's Thelma.
Oh, really? Okay.
I think she's going
to
stay.
I think she's going to go.
I don't know how to say goodbye to you.
You know what the truth is?
What?
When people you love, there's never enough time.
No, no, no.
So when people die and you're like, I wish I had more time, you'll always wish them.
Yeah, of course.
Hey, ladies. Time's running out.
I love the ponytail.
Did you clock that George Washington ponytail in the back?
I love
work
it.
Bitch.
The little love.
She's in heaven and she has one hair tie.
Bye-bye, girls.
Well, that was season 7 of Grace and Frankie.
This show has it all.
Wigs.
Gay sex.
Lily Tomlin.
Fights.
Jane Fonda.
Deaths.
Dolly Parton.
Friendship.
Yes, and most importantly, dense, exciting roles for women of a certain age.
Complex female characters delivered right to your TV screen. So why don't you please go ahead and check out the final season of Grace and Frankie here on Netflix.
Goodbye.
Bye.